Hola a todos. Hoy vamos a comenzar aprendiendo trabalenguas en español. La razón por la que les quiero enseñar trabalenguas es para que vayan practicando la pronunciación y el oído. Hi everybody. What I just said in Spanish is, today we will begin to practice some Spanish tongue twisters or tongue twisters in Spanish, okay? The reason why I have chosen this is to make you practice your pronunciation, to become more fluent and a bit to loosen your tongue a bit, and to practice as well your hearing, okay? And also, while we learn the tongue twisters, we'll have the chance to speak and to talk a bit about grammar and learn new vocabulary, okay? So, our title today, nuestro título de hoy, is Trabalenguas en español, trabalenguas en español, or tongue twisters in Spanish, right? Or Spanish tongue twisters. Entonces comenzaremos con un trabalenguas que no es muy corto. So we will begin today with a tongue twister that is not really very short, pero tampoco es un trabalenguas difícil. But it's not a difficult tongue twister either. Okay, so you can see in blue we have the tongue twister in Spanish and in black the translation, the English translation. Podemos ver que en color azul tenemos el trabalenguas en español y en color negro he escrito la traducción en inglés. Comencemos entonces a hablar del vocabulario que veremos hoy. Let's begin then with learning the vocabulary that we will see today in this tongue twister, okay? In the first place, primero, Cuesta is a last name. Cuesta is a Spanish last name or family name, okay? That's why we have it written in capital. And here, Cuesta is a conjugated verb. It comes, the infinitive is costar. Costar means to cost, right? Esto cuesta mucho dinero. This costs a lot of money, okay? To cost. But also, costar has another meaning as well. To costar means something implies a great effort, yes? So, If I can say in Spanish, me cuesta mucho caminar. Me cuesta mucho caminar. This means, it is a great effort to walk. Another example, me cuesta levantar esto. This means, I find it hard to lift this, or I find it difficult to lift this. It doesn't mean that you cannot. It just means that it's hard and you find it difficult, right? But it does not mean necessarily that you cannot do it, okay? And in this sense, costar is a reflexive verb, in the sense of, I say, a mí me cuesta levantar esto. To me, it is hard to lift this, okay? Or, to him, it is hard to run faster, yes? In Spanish, we would say, a él le cuesta correr más rápido. So you can see it's reflexive. That's why we have cuesta is the person, okay? The person. And we say a cuesta le cuesta means to Mr. Cuesta, he finds himself difficult to climb the slope, okay? So one of the interesting things in this tongue twister is that there are so many similar words that have different meaning. I will say this in Spanish now. Una de las cosas interesantes de este trabalenguas es que hay varias palabras en español que son iguales o parecidas, pero que tienen significados diferentes. Por ejemplo, Cuesta es un nombre propio o un apellido. Cuesta here is a given name, right? Or better said, it's a family name. Cuesta aquí significa, viene del verbo costar. Cuesta here comes from the verb costar. Y cuesta es un sustantivo. Here, cuesta is a noun. That means slope. Una cuesta is a slope. Okay, so you can see how we have three words that are the same but have different meanings. Okay? Subir means to climb. To climb. To climb, but also to go up. For example, el ascensor está subiendo. The elevator is going up, right? So not necessarily climb, but also to go up. So subir has a broader meaning than the English verb to climb. En medio de means in the middle of, okay? But en medio de means refers to a situation, right? Not a physical location. When we want to say in the middle of something, right, physically, we would add the article here. We would say en el medio de, en el medio de. But when we refer to a situation, we don't include the article. We say en medio de, okay? In the middle of the slope, in the middle of the slope, he goes and lays down, okay? Remember that va is the conjugated form in present tense for the third person of a singular of the verb to go, that in Spanish is ir. And acuesta comes from the verb acostar. Acostar means to lay or to lay down, right? Actually, acostar means to lay something on some place, okay? But if it becomes reflexive, acostarse, then it means to lay down, okay? Acostarse would literally mean to lay oneself, okay? I lay myself. This means I lay down, right? So, here you can see how in Spanish this verb is reflexive. Se acuesta. He lays himself, okay? Means he lays down. So you can see here four words that are identical or almost identical and have four different meanings. Cuesta as a family name. Cuesta as the verb costar. Cuesta, that means a slope. And acuesta from the verb acostarse, that means to lay down. Okay, tenemos cuatro palabras que son idénticas o casi idénticas. Casi idénticas means almost identical, pero que tienen cuatro significados diferentes. So, now let's begin to read our tongue twister slowly, okay? And then we will gradually read it faster. Vamos a comenzar a leer nuestro trabalenguas. Comenzaremos leyendo palabra por palabra. Despacio, slowly, despacio, y de a poco, slowly or gradually, de a poco iremos leyéndolo más rápido, faster. A cuesta le cuesta subir la cuesta, y en medio de la cuesta va y se acuesta. A cuesta le cuesta subir la cuesta, y en medio de la cuesta va y se acuesta. Again, a cuesta le cuesta subir la cuesta, y en medio de la cuesta va y se acuesta. Okay, this is a very easy tongue twister because it doesn't have the too much of the R sound, right? R or many consonants together, right? So, but the reason why I want to practice tongue twisters with you is it's a fun way to learn new vocabulary, new grammar, or to review some grammar, and also practice pronunciation and our hearing, okay? Por lo tanto, la razón o el objetivo principal por el que quiero enseñarles trabalenguas es porque aprendiendo trabalenguas es una muy buena oportunidad para aprender nuevo vocabulario, para aprender nuevas cosas de gramática, o incluso para rever cosas que ya hemos aprendido de gramática, y también nos da una oportunidad